I don't want anyone else to be kneeling by the side of the road because their child's gone.
A family heartbroken.
I just want her back. I don't know about them. I think they're angry. I know Chase says he wants him in jail. But to me, it doesn't matter. I just want her back.
A hit-and-run driver ran over 8-year-old Layla Aiken as she waited for her school bus in Cape Coral.
She was a beautiful girl. I mean, she just, she had a passion for reading like I do. I mean, her nose was always in the book.
Her twin brothers witnessing their sister's horrific death.
And all I ask is to keep praying for our family because we're hurting. To pray for my boys who are going to have a lot to deal with in the years to come.
We just learned police found the truck and have a person of interest. Good evening, I'm Kelly Burns.
And I'm Peter Bush. NBC2 has team coverage tonight on this story. Megan Bragg has new information on the police investigation. But first, Joanna Boris is at the bus stop at the intersection of Northeast 3rd Avenue and 19th Terrace. She spoke to Layla Aiken's parents.
Layla Aiken's father told me this was his little girl's second time at this bus stop. The family saying they never imagined it would be her last.
She was a beautiful girl. I mean, she just, she had a passion for reading like I do. I mean, her nose was always in the book.
Glenn Aiken says he never imagined he'd be talking about his 8-year-old daughter in past tense, not knowing who stole her life from her.
Just come forward, you know, just to own it. It's only March. I mean, how many more kids have to die?
Layla was hit and killed by a truck at her bus stop yesterday.
Really, it's close to home. How many people send out pieces of their heart every morning to walk to the bus?
Layla's mom, Kathleen, says she and her kids had talked about an emergency plan for walking to the bus stop.
We had talked about it before. We had talked about what we do because we know it's dark and we know it's early.
In case something like this ever happened. Never thinking they'd have to use it.
This could have been anybody's child.
Now the parents say something has to change.
Oh, the whole process isn't safe. Well, that's why we had a plan. That's why the kids knew that it was a possibility. I knew that it's dark and you're walking. It's not even just the stops. They have to walk. They have to cross roads.
Adding to the tragedy, Layla's 9-year-old twin brothers witnessed the whole thing.
Unfortunately. From our talks, they remember every detail.
Like trying to save their little sister's life.
Jay stayed with her, and at one point, he even tried to save her, tried CPR. They had to go through the worst of it. 9-year-old boys were left to try and save her because someone else left.
Now, all the family is left with are memories.
You know, now we're left to pick up the pieces.
The father says the services are scheduled for next Wednesday at Gallagher's funeral home from 5 to 7 and that everyone is invited. Live in Cape Coral, Joanna Boris, NBC2.